It's Dahlia time, and I'm at the best place. I'm at Swan Island Dahlias with Heather. And Heather, this has been a kind of funky year, just so much heat, but the dahlias look great.
It has been a hard year, definitely a struggle of a farming year, and I think everybody's had to learn and adjust in their own home yards. We are about 2 weeks behind, and that is from the heat that we saw in July when the tender little plants were just getting a start. So they kind of just took a hibernation period and slowed down to survive, I think probably like the rest of us. but they're coming along. We're definitely catching up. So.
Yeah. Well, I know the ones in my yard are great, and these are beautiful. So what should we be doing differently, or what should we do now?
You know, every year dahlias need a lot of water. They need deep water. That's traditional, nothing different. And they definitely need fertilizer, which a lot of people think they don't, but they really do. But when you have an extreme weather year like we're having this year with all of these high temps and longer periods of warm weather, we have to even more increase the fertilizer and more water. And dahlias need deep watering, and I think that's really tricky, and that most people think I can just hose water or hand water for a few minutes and move on, and it just doesn't get deep enough.
So slower.
Slower for longer periods of time will actually make you have to water less often, so you could do that every other day rather than every day for 5 minutes or 30 seconds on a plant. It really just doesn't get deep enough, so you need a soaker hose or a sprinkler and really watch to see if that water's getting deep enough. If you're not getting blooms, they're just hibernating, telling you, you're not giving me enough.
Yeah, they're amazing root systems. I mean, you wouldn't think that those kind of plants would have, but I remember digging them up with your dad and seeing those roots. So really, you need to get that water down into the ground.
We really want it down 8-10 inches deep, and that kind of seems weird. But your annuals and things, your petunias are real shallow little roots, but your dahlias are gonna have nice and deep roots, which is good in that if you deep water, they can actually maintain better. But if you're watering shallow, they're never going to bloom and thrive like they should.
Definitely. And then fertilizer, that's really important.
Yeah, so normally we say low nitrogen fertilizer. Dahlias do need food and they do need some nitrogen. We just don't want a miracle grower overdo them too often. And so we really recommend if they're in pots about every 2 weeks fertilizing, if they're in the ground about every 3 weeks. But this year with the heat, think about like yourself, you need more water, more food. So during those heat stress periods, you're gonna have to shorten up your period between fertilizing. And I would say giving them a high dose of nitrogen once during the growing season, especially during the stressful time, will not hurt them at all. And then go back to your lower nitrogen, but that will help push that plant along that might be just kind of struggling to get going.
Sure. And so you have that kind of fertilizer here. You have one that's really calculated for dahlias.
We do. We have a great one.
You know, Heather, I need to get some more dahlias for next year. So how do I do that?
Best way to do it is to go online. We're offering 10% off through the end of September to allow everybody to order online. Sit at home. Once you've come out here and picked out your favorites, you can sit at home and pick them out and place your order.
Great. We're talking about coming out here.
Yes.
So what's going on with the festival this year?
You know, so the festival's a little different. Really, the only difference is that we've spread ourselves out over 2 months. And we just don't have an indoor display. For the safety of everybody, it was the best decision. We had to make that early in the spring.
Sure.
And where we were at that time was why we made the decision. So, but we've changed a lot and added a lot in that we've got classes, yoga, farmers market. There's lots of different things happening. We've got free music concerts, rotating food carts. So there's lots to see along with the gorgeous flowers.
Yeah, and that hasn't changed. You can still go see all the beautiful flowers, take pictures, and get bouquets.
Of course, cut flowers every day. We're just closed on Wednesdays.
But you know, things change, but everything is still the same. And it's a wonderful experience to come out here any day for a long, long time. So please go to Garden Time. We'll click you over to their website. You can see all the information there and come out and see these amazing dahlias. Heather, thanks so much.
Thank you.